is Bruno Loyer with Siemens PLM Software. In a previous video, I had demonstrated an optimization with LMS Imagine Lab AmSims built-in design exploration tool. Now, in this second video, still based on our injector system, I will demonstrate a Monte Carlo analysis done on this injector system. Coming back to our injector model, we will assume that it has been optimized using LMS AmSims optimization features. We will now study the variability of its performance with respect to the variability of two diameters, diameter A and diameter Z. So we will start our design optimization tool here, as in the previous video, but now we have defined a Monte Carlo analysis. When we open this design exploration study, we can see that we can define several parameters: the number of runs, here 1000, the sampling method, here we have selected Latin hypercube, which is a good compromise. And here we see that as controls parameters, we can find diameter A and diameter Z. We assume that these parameters were following a normal law, which means a Gaussian distribution, and we can see here the mean values and standard deviations associated with these normal laws. And then we can see the responses of our model, and here we will specifically take a look at pre-injected quantity and main injected quantity that are crucial, especially in the case of multiple injections. So here we are able to start the optimization by clicking on this button. Now that the Monte Carlo analysis is complete, we can see that we dispose of various kinds of specialized plots that can be used. For instance, histograms here, but we also have scatter plots, history plots, and response surfaces. So for instance, we can check that diameter A was indeed following a normal law. And here, we see that indeed, the distribution is very similar to a Gaussian. We can also plot several scatter plots, and while doing so on the quantities of interest, meaning the pre-injected quantity and the main injected quantity, we can see the correlations between these quantities and diameter A or diameter Z. And what appears very clearly regarding the pre-injected quantity is that it is very well spread over the many runs, which shows that it is difficult to control, especially by means of diameter A. Whereas some clearer correlation seems to appear with diameter Z. However, we can see that the main injected quantity seems to be more controllable with diameter Z and to a lesser extent with diameter A. So this concludes this second video, and what needs to be retained from the design exploration features of LMS AmSim is that you can define DOEs to get a better understanding of the physical phenomena that are being put into play. You can also optimize your design, and you can use Monte Carlo analysis to assess its robustness. Thus, engineers can discover and rectify sensitive elements in their design. I would even say failure-prone elements. Also, engineers can proactively suggest improvement directions. And also, it is possible to manage costs by balancing functional tolerances with system operation. And lastly, I would say that with the design exploration, you can handle the trade-off between the pure performance of your design and its robustness. Last but not least, note that all the design exploration features that we have demonstrated in these two videos can be used offline, meaning without even opening the LMS AmSim GUI. We have powerful APIs for that, available in various scripting languages. And also, these powerful features can be used on high-performance computing. Thank you for watching, and for more information, please visit our website.